Into the crack house, into the crack house, into the crack house.
Greetings, this is Fritz, and you're listening to Minisode 2. I am joined, as always, by co-host Mandaddy.
Hi.
Kaz.
Hello.
Angela.
Hello.
And we've got Nick Spry.
Greetings.
And this is when we just briefly tell you what's going on in the world of paranormal or otherwise spooky. So this came out the day after Mother's Day, but HBO launched this series called, Mommy Dead and Dearest.
Oof.
And it's about this woman, Dee Blanchard, who basically through Munchausen by proxy, convinces her and everyone around her that her daughter has severe mental retardation. Like she's half blind. She can't hear. She can't taste anything. She's got cancer and a bad ticker.
Wow.
But she doesn't actually have those things.
But Gypsy Rose, her daughter, at
serious?
The age of 19, basically becomes so trapped. She feels so trapped. She kills her mother. And it's just watching these clips where this young girl is pretending like she's dying is the craziest thing in the entire world. And you know that her mother put her up to
convinced?
This. She pretended because she gives a striking interview basically saying, what else could I do? I had no other recourse.
Huh.
Wow.
Absolutely fascinating. That's HBO. If you have HBO Go. Go ahead and give that one a gander.
Terrifying.
That's messed up. It released that right before Mother's Day.
Day after.
Oh, the day after.
They're okay. Like, good? You guys good? You guys set? You guys scared? Because your fucking daughter's going to kill you.
And I know all you paranormal nerds were wondering why, you know, she was named after the two rival sisters from the musical Gypsy. That's the first thing that I thought. Gypsy Rose. Man.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, the musical Gypsy.
Fucking theater nerds.
That old chestnut.
It's a Venn diagram. There's got to be an overlap somewhere.
Yeah, like you and one other person.
You shut your mouth, man, father.
You will address me as your father.
You and the writer of Gypsy.
Of course a woman like that would name her kid Gypsy Rose, right? Like, just be
yeah.
Like,
just because you need another stripper in the world.
Right, exactly.
It's such a just fascinating and really sad story, but at the same time.
What, strippers?
You're just, well, Dad, yeah.
Well.
Anybody have anything?
A noble profession.
Yeah, I got an addition to the lexicon of the spooky dictionary this week.
Nice.
Okay.
So, to increase your vocabulary, instead of using the word spooky, this week's word is uncanny.
Ooh.
That's uncanny, uncanny.
Use it in a sentence, please.
It was uncanny the way my son would forge my signature on checks to himself.
All right.
Pretty spooky. Okay. Why the hell did you go there?
That's pretty
spooky.
Yeah.
I mean, uncanny means strange or mysterious, especially in unsettling way. So that would be, you know, disturbing and be like, oh, man, my son's got my signature down.
Yeah.
It's uncanny.
It's uncanny.
This guy's been practicing in his room.
So if it makes complete sense, is it canny?
Canny would be the opposite, but the word over the centuries is kind of the word canny basically means having or showing a shrewdness and good judgment, especially in money or business matters. It comes from an old Scots in around the 1500s, the 16th century, meaning the word can would mean no. Like, I can means I know.
Mm.
I've heard that, like you can.
In a really thick Scottish accent.
Yeah,
just like that.
Spell just like C-A-N, can?
Yep, or she's a canny lass. She's in the
know. Comely? Comely and canny was she.
God.
But basically, over the years since the 15th century, or 16th century, it's become to be associated, I guess, around the 18th century with specifically the supernatural, the word uncanny. Hmm. Like it meant malicious or somehow underhanded or something that it was attributed to ghosts and ghouls and the supernatural.
The demon was uncanny, I tell you.
Yes. Yeah, and probably the most prominent use of that word nowadays would be in like the uncanny X-Men in the comics.
Oh, yeah. Uncanny and paranormal.
Wow, I never thought about that.
And phenomenal.
That. Uncanny.
Huh. Very nice.
Didn't
anything
make
else?
Sense before,
no, I think that's it for this
uncanny.
Week.
Uncanny. Uncanny.
I never thought about the Uncanny X-Men that way. Yeah. I just kind of accept it.
It's a little bit strange or mysterious.
Just change it. Yeah.
Especially in an unsettling manner.
And then also, after, like, you know, a couple hundreds of years, like, if you don't like that definition, be like, oh, let's change it.
So do you like classic X-Men, like, you know, where it was just Beast and Charles in the yellow black suits?
Well, X-Men was a reprint of the second coming of the X-Men when they first introduced Storm and Wolverine.
Yeah. And
those books were called classic X-Men. So that, to me, that's classic X-Men. And yes, that is my favorite incarnation of the X-Men.
Nice.
Awesome. Yeah.
I knew you had one. That's absolutely sure. This is a go-to.
Everyone's got one.
I liked Naked Blue Beast instead of Man Beast in the black.
More like he was. Like a,
you like Naked Blue
naked
Beast?
Yeah. Blue Beast. Yeah.
Or panties. He had panties on. Panties with the...
panties?
They were like ex-panties.
We're getting to
like
the utility belt. Now, how does that make you feel?
You don't have to answer that. You don't have to answer that.
Panties.
So, you got something there?
I do. We're going to do some more horror, spooky, entertainment news. First of all, Alien Covenant coming out Friday.
Yes!
I'm pretty stoked about that. I'm definitely going to go see that.
So, Ridley Scott is directing that?
Yes.
Awesome. Yeah. God, that is so cool.
It looks really cool. I'm excited about that.
And Danny McBride. It's got Danny McBride. That makes
sure.
everything
oh, yeah.
better.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting segue. Actually, Danny McBride is assisting in the reshoot of a new Halloween movie.
Oh, what?
Oh, that's cool.
So that'll be another.
And I heard that.
I don't know if it's going to be good or not. It sounds like.
And I think, aren't they saying that they're going to make it where Michael Myers isn't supernatural or anything like that? Where there's no.
It's just Danny McBride.
I haven't read too many
Danny McBride killing people.
Danny McBride as Michael Myers.
Yes. Danny McBride. Not even wearing Michael masks. Myers.
Like, sup, bro? You're dead now.
Yeah. He's got like a really funny quip.
Yeah. He's like still endearing.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's okay. You can kill me. You're just. Okay.
The other weird one.
Wait, are you Danny Every kill.
Like the weird little scraggly beard poking out from under the mask.
Yeah.
So the other weird one that I saw was they're going to make a Ted Bundy biopic.
Oh.
And it's going to be starring, drum roll, Zac Efron.
Really?
As wow.
Ted Bundy.
Oh.
Trying to go against type, I see.
Yeah. Well, I already said that Ted Bundy was very handsome.
Yep.
Handsome.
Well,
I'm saying type when it comes to
casting-wise.
Yeah. You don't see Zach doing many dark characters.
Oh, from High School Musical to that.
I was thinking Ted Bundy the musical would be even better.
And he's going to take his shirt off and you're going to go, damn!
In the courtroom as he's defending himself as Ted Bundy. He's like, look at these abs!
Kidnap me, Ted.
Look at me.
I tell you, not guilty!
I think Love Bites, the Ted Bundy musical.
Ooh.
Oh.
I could see it. Yeah, I could see it because that's how he got convicted, is because of bite marks. That's because of
that's
teeth
true.
Impressions.
That's
you ever done the Ted Bundy trail up in Jacksonville?
There's a Ted Bundy trail?
Yeah, the FSU. Because he did
Tallahassee.
Tallahassee, I'm sorry.
FSU.
You're talking to a Knoll.
You know, I live here too.
Here and there.
I just get confused.
Live around.
We all do. Because we live here.
I fall down a lot.
Oh, you do, actually. You need to start wearing a helmet.
Yeah.
Simon Pegg and Nick Frost are also going to make another sort of horror comedy movie. It's going to be called Slaughterhouse Rules.
Nice.
Some sort of boarding house horror
slasher
movie.
I thought you were going to say that they were going to be in the Ted Bundy movie as like his bumbling best friend.
Just like this endearing
you
Ted
put
Bundy
the
story.
In the boot of the car.
the like comic relief. In there.
So that's it for spooky news.
Nice, very nice,
and,
nicely done.
I believe that Angela has something add to the Minnesota.
Well, I found this to be not so much spooky, but really disturbing.
Okay, right.
Possibly uncanny.
Then that's perfect.
Possibly uncanny. They now have rompers for men.
What's
no?
What's a romper?
You know, it's like a little onesie suit.
Okay.
You know, it's got little shorts.
Does it have the little patch bottom?
Well,
so you can go dookie.
The article is the male romper is here, and you can pee in it.
Oh,
Well, technically, you can pee in anything.
Yeah,
I mean,
does it have some sort of fabric or like?
It's like boxers.
It has like,
you know?
Oh, there's an opening.
Yeah,
okay,
there's
okay.
an opening.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Yeah, which I have to say, I'm very resentful about because as a woman, we do not have that option.
Yeah,
that's true. So if you're wearing a romper, you got to go. Full on.
Oh, it's you're vulnerable like when you're camping. It's terrible.
It's fucking hilarious. Yeah.
Yeah, just picture me and Kaz wearing some floral rompers.
Dude. I actually, even if it was just
you wearing some rompers. That's what I was going to say. Yeah.
Yeah.
The rompers right they're like more alley. Casual than pajamas.
They are. They're casual pajamas.
My boss was wondering, I have to ask you, so do you, like, when you get home, you change into different pajamas? I'm like, yes, I do. I have work pajamas and I have home pajamas. Yeah, I mean, I'm not a freaking monster.
I'm not a savage.
You put on a pleated pair of Dockers when you get home.
Full tux, business suit sometimes. I sleep in a three-piece suit.
Actually, that's true. I have, like, lounging around the house pajamas and then, like, sleeping pajamas.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. I mean, who doesn't? Now, these rompers, are they called anything? Like, what? It's not like Lululemon or...
Well, the company is called Romp Him.
Romp Him.
Yeah.
Sounds more like a command.
And they actually have a Kickstarter if you guys would like to donate.
Nice. Of course.
How much
do.
is this going for? Are they trying to sell them for, like $1.29 or something like disposables?
If they're having a Kickstarter, they're just basically saying, give us some money, and we'll give you a romper.
They're like, give us money, and then you get one piece of clothing to put on.
Right. Well, there you go. There's a Kickstarter for a romper. Yeah. If anyone's
do you guys want to get rompers?
I thought you'd never ask.
Team rompers?
Leap over!
Woo!
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
That's never going to happen.
What about you, man? Daddy, you got one?
Yeah, I got something interesting. I like to bring up, first of all, isn't it great that Kickstarter is either... bizarre products that you never thought you needed, bands you never heard about, or healthcare.
Yeah, that's it.
It's just fun little things, or people are dying and need your cash.
There's nothing else.
Yeah, that's all you got. What I got is, now there's been, for the last decade or so, there's been a lot of reports of sighting of things called shadow people. And these are similar to the things that people see when they go through sleep paralysis. And we all know about that fun experience. But, you know, dark, shadowy figures that appear. But this is when you're awake or like, you know, almost like ghosts in your house down hallways. And they always seem to have a malevolence to them, or they seem to bring a positivity. It's either one or the other. It seems to be a light or dark thing. Some people have reported seeing shadow people and actually feeling a warmth and a positivity from them. But it's more evil.
Is this the dude what got the hat on his head, too?
That's the new one. The new sighting is, over the last few years now, has become the Hat Man.
The Hat Man,
because they have really creative people working in the paranormal name-giving business.
Because it's still scary as hell. Yeah, Hat Man.
It's the same sort of dark, shadowy thing, but it's got a long, wide-brimmed hat and, like, a trench coat, and they say it almost seems like it's floating, where you can never really see its lower half of its body.
Hipster scarecrow hats, like those Amish hats that all the hipsters wear.
Yeah, kind of like that.
Yeah.
Are you sure it's not just a guy who just can't afford rent? Just like, I'm just going to stand here.
That would be a classic hipster.
Is he wearing a sun hat?
Well, it's Florida. You have to be careful, even if you're a shadow person.
Sun hat is like the least spooky of all hats. It's not. You see someone wearing a sun hat, they're immediately like 10 times less threatening than
that. What about one of those umbrella hats?
Oh, with a
no! That person's a psychopath. Any given moment.
Yeah, no, exactly.
Yeah, no.
That is a person unhinged.
Yeah.
That is wearing that hat. Outside party guy, inside a house psychopath.
A roller coaster of nightmares.
You just described my childhood.
So with the Hat Man, what does he? Does he scratch you?
They say, like, this is what I was talking about earlier, is that with this one there, because you can actually, there is now the hatmanproject.com.
And this is a new sighting?
It's been over the last few years is the Hat Man has come into prevalence.
Interesting.
Meaning that there'll be a cheaply produced movie on Netflix about him in 3, 4,
let's jump
go.
On that. Let's jump on it right now.
I think we're making it right now.
Let's do it.
Someone put on a hat. It looks spooky. Oh, got it. But
Nick's like, I'm not doing anything.
According to this one person, he looked blacker than night. I could feel the evil.
So he's like Vanta black.
Yeah, just darker than dark, and that, you know,
newly created in a NASA lab.
And sometimes he has henchmen, like these noisy creatures that have clacking and creaking sounds around them, while he just kind of hovers, you know, in between them, like micromanaging the situation by making them creak or bump at his will.
All right,
really. Manages his social media accounts.
Hatman on Twitter is hilarious.
His
totally
very
spooked out 12 year old today, LOL, you know,
various offshore accounts.
But that's what's going on, so cool. be on the lookout in your house late at night for the possibility of meeting the Hat Man.
That's creepy as hell. Well, there you go. If any of that interests you, you want to hear stuff, call 570-478-3789. That's 570-4RT-FRTZ. We got a Facebook. What's that, Kaz? Facebook. What's a Facebook?
Facebook. What turn around. It's right over there. There's a Facebook. It's down, right.
Did it find us? Oh, my there God. Facebook can see you. Facebook is, I don't know, it's a thing. It's on the internet.
But what's our address?
Facebook.com/FortFritz. Nice. And then a Twitter.
Okay. Oh, there's a Twitter,
too. We have a Twitter at Fort Fritz MCT.
MCT.
MCT. Mm-hmm. Yo, MCT, coming right at you.
Yeah, what up?
Boom!
Awesome. Anything else? Instagram?
We have a soon-to-be-launched Instagram account coming up that should be at Fort Fritz, but I'm just going to make sure that it works first, and then we'll confirm awesome. That.
Then we'll announce that.
We're just on all the platforms.
Well, we're
it's annoying.
Angel, you got any shout-outs?
I love you guys.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for listening to Fort Fritz Minnesota 2. Bye.